Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and today Apple released iOS 16.1.2 to the public. This is available to everyone everywhere around the world at the exact same time if you have a compatible device, which means an iPhone 8, 8 Plus, or all the way up to the iPhone 14 Pro and 14 Pro Max. And if you're wondering how to install the update, maybe you're not seeing it yet, go to your settings, go to general, then go to software update. If you're still not seeing it, go into automatic updates, turn off automatic updates, and then check again and you should see it. Now, if you're a beta tester, you won't have this update because you're on a newer version of iOS 16.2. So the only way you would be able to install this is you would have to use a computer to restore and downgrade. Then you could install from iOS 16.1.1 or older to the newest 16.1.2. But as you can see, this came in at a pretty small 336.2 megabytes. That's on my iPhone 14 Pro Max. But Apple did not release any other updates. They didn't release iPadOS, watchOS, or anything else along with this. Now let's go ahead and take a look at the build number and talk about what's new. So we'll go to settings, then we'll go back to general, then about. And as you can see, this update is 20B110. This update includes improvements and bug fixes for your phone. And this should probably be one of the last updates that actually needs to be installed with a full update if it's just security updates and bug fixes, as Apple will be pushing out rapid security response updates soon, as you can see here with the latest betas. So we'll see more of that in the future. Now, as far as what's new, well, there is no modem update in this particular update, and so there shouldn't be any changes there. However, the new features, changes, and updates actually have to do specifically with the modem. So even though they didn't upgrade that, they did update wireless carrier compatibility according to Apple. So if you were having issues with 5G or 4G and overall compatibility, that should be improved according to Apple. However, I have confirmed that there is no 5G in India yet for iPhones. That would be releasing probably with iOS 16.2. So that seems to be the most likely scenario for that, unless they need to delay it for some reason. But this should improve overall compatibility and hopefully make things much better. In this update, they've also fixed crash detection. They said they've optimized it for iPhone 14 and 14 Pro models, meaning maybe it won't detect when you're on a roller coaster. Maybe it's optimized to know when you're in a different theme park and not trigger when you're on a roller coaster. They haven't said specifically what they're going to fix with that, but that's something that they could update. Now you can disable crash detection if you want to while you're in a theme park. You can just go into your settings, go to emergency SOS, and under emergency SOS, you can turn off call after severe crash. That will stop triggering it. Then you can turn it back on as you leave that theme park. So maybe they've fixed some things here. We'll have to wait and see if there's any different reaction once you're on a roller coaster or something like that. Now, one thing I wanted to check with is with iOS 16.1.1, Apple enabled an AirDrop limitation in China. And I wanted to see if they were bringing that to the US, as some people have said they are. However, it does not appear to be there. So in China, everyone is limited to 10 minutes. And this is something that isn't in the US, thankfully. So it was a way apparently people were passing around information and they limited it to 10 minutes. Now in the US, it's said that it's coming later. I don't see it here, thankfully, and it's not there. So if you were wondering about that. As far as additional bug fixes, well, some people said that the Wi-Fi issue was not fixed with iOS 16.1.1, so there could be improvements, but Apple hasn't said anything specifically with this. However, so far it seems to be a good connection. I haven't seen it drop yet. I've also not seen any issues with storage bugs under settings, so if we go back and go to general and then iPhone storage, I would expect it to be about what you would expect. In fact, that's probably the fastest I've ever seen it load. So if we scroll down, you'll see it's still loading system data, but this can change regularly based on what you're actually doing with the phone. So I really wouldn't pay too much attention to that. Typically, the iOS update will stay around 9 gigabytes or so, and you'll see system data on this phone is taking up 3.8 gigabytes, but that could go all the way up to 20. I've seen it as high as 100 gigabytes or more, just depending on what you're using it with. But let me know if you've seen anything different there in the comments below. Now, just like any other iOS update, we'll have security updates in this as well. And if we go to this link here, where we go to support.apple.com, that's actually the security website, and you can see that here. Now, in the future with iOS 16.2, we'll have security updates that are pushed separately from regular updates, making it much faster to get those. You can see that here with iOS 16.2 betas, where we have rapid security response updates. However, we're not seeing those yet, so probably after 16.2. But if you go to the security website, you can see here it says iOS 16.1.2, iPhone 8 and later, and then it says when it was released. It so far has not been updated with those specific updates for security. So they typically update these a couple hours after the update is out for some reason. But you'll see that here, what they've resolved and what they've actually fixed in this particular update. Now, as far as additional bugs or anything else, well, we'll have to see how this is over the next few days. And of course, I'll have a follow-up on the weekend talking about all of that. However, as far as battery life, that will take a few days to measure. Overall battery life can vary greatly depending on how you use your device. So on iOS 16.2, I've been running regularly, and I've also had follow-up videos talking to many of you. Many of you said iOS 16.1.1 improved battery life, but then it started to degrade over time. I've seen the same sort of behavior with 16.2, so I'm not really getting through a day with less than or more than, say, 40%. So at this point, give it a few days, and then we'll be able to check that and see what it's like. As far as overall performance, so far it's super smooth. As far as going into different apps or going into the app library and scrolling, nice and smooth as you would expect. Opening things like music, of course, nice and fast. No issues there. And also we have the music replay year in music. So these are specific to everyone's music tastes. And if you go to this, it brings you to a website and you sign in. And then you'll see your replay and see the different information about what you listen to most. And it talks all about that. So be sure to check that out if you use Apple Music. Now, as far as benchmarks, let's take a look at that, as I did run them quickly on this device. And you can see here, for single core, it scored 1,883. Multi-core was 4,883. Multi-core is actually a little bit down on the initial run of this from the previous version, but the single core is up. So I would expect this to improve over time. And it's actually significantly down by about 700 almost, or 600 or so. So that's something that should improve over time. I could run it again and get different results. Typically right after it restarts, you'll see that. And as far as the overall heat of the device, so far it's not very warm. It's a little bit warm under the camera, but that's to be expected as it's processing a lot of things in the background. So no issues there. It's staying nice and cool so far. And I really wouldn't expect any difference there, as this is a minor bug fix update. Now, if you're wondering if you should install iOS 16.1.2, I would say absolutely, because of the security updates. And being a minor update, I really wouldn't expect it to have much of an impact on anything else with your phone. So as they update this website, check it out and see what they've actually patched, but typically they're pretty important, and I definitely recommend installing it. As far as future updates, well, iOS 16.2 Beta 4, I would expect as soon as tomorrow. Last year, we saw it on a Thursday after Thanksgiving, the week after Thanksgiving. I would expect the same thing tomorrow on December 1st. This, of course, could change, but typically that's what we'll have. And then maybe the following week, we'll see iOS 16.2 RC, or release candidate. And then we'll have the public release probably the week after that, like we did last year on a Monday. So probably December 12th or 13th is when I would expect the final release. And then probably no other betas until January, like they did last year as well, with iOS 16.3. That could change, of course, but at this point, that's typically what Apple's been following this entire year, usually what they're doing last year. Sometimes they change it a little bit, but that's usually what we see. And so that's everything in iOS 16.1.2. Not a ton of different changes or updates, but some nice bug fixes, and hopefully our carrier signal gets much, much better. I'll be testing that over the next few days and seeing how it is as far as overall connectivity and more. If you've found anything else in this particular update, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.